Why are some people left-handed? Because they are evil and in congress with the devil. Not a very popular point of view these days, I'll admit, but one that was very prevalent back in the days of old when knights were bold. And back then, anybody who used their left hand dominantly was thought to be at best a bit odd, and at worst, in league with Beelzebub. It's why the word sinister comes from the Latin sinistra, meaning of the left. And yet, throughout human history, around 10% of us have used our left hand dominantly for most tasks, with slightly more men than women being left-handed. Researchers even proved that some Neanderthals were left-dominant. For a while, it was believed that left-handed people had their brains wired differently. Some do, in fact. Most humans use the left hemisphere of their brain to speak and to understand language, between 75 and 90% of us, according to scholarly types. Because using your dominant hand requires a similar amount of brain power, it was reckoned for a long time that the other half of your brain must therefore be used for doing this. So, the majority of us are right-handed. But this doesn't quite stack up. Around 30% of left-handers do indeed have reverse brain lateralisation, or no dominant side at all. But the vast majority of them still use the left-hand brain for language. Same as normal people. Another big factor is definitely your genes, as with height, body shape, and being ginger, left-handedness can be transmitted from generation to generation. If both of your parents are leftists, then there's a 26% chance that you will be too, more than double the normal odds. It's also possible that your hand preference is established sometime before you even arrive in the world. Premature babies are more likely to be left-handed. There's also some evidence that ultrasonic scans increase the chances of a baby being a left-hander. All of which is an elaborate way of saying nobody really knows. But being left-dominant does give you one or two interesting advantages and a couple of major drawbacks as well. Let's start with the downsides. Around 20% of people who develop schizophrenia are left-handed. They're also more prone, apparently, to dyslexia and ADHD. They also have a reputation for being more angry than the rest of us. On the plus side, though, they are less susceptible to ulcers and arthritis. There's also plenty of evidence that left-handed people are more creative. A disproportionate number of great artists painted with their left hand. Leftists are also better at getting elected, it would seem, at least judging by recent American history, because four of the last seven presidents have been lefties: Obama, Clinton, Bush Sr., and Gerald Ford. Left-handers also do well in sport and, if we go back far enough, fighting. This is because a left-hander has a distinct advantage over a right-handed opponent who will probably only ever have faced other right-handed people. That makes them particularly vulnerable to a sudden southpaw. But as a minority, left-handers, like nudists, have long had to accept that the world is failing to adapt to them. Dozens and dozens of everyday items, from corkscrews to scissors and even books, are designed for right-hand use. On the plus side, left-handers have their own day to celebrate being a bit different. There are also special left-handed shops where you can buy left-handed everyday tools and even left-handed pianos.